The next display area we want to look at today is the CIA, which stands for Central Information Area. And the central information area always defaults to the bottom of one of our internal screens or one of our external screens, and it can be considered a soft extension of your programming surface. The CIA is broken up into two main areas. The first area on your left are what are called the parameter tiles, and then on the right-hand side is the browser. If we want to draw focus to the CIA, we can use our displays button, and you'll notice that we'll put a gold highlight around the browser. And once I'm in the CIA, I can use my page up and page down arrows to navigate. And if there is a node next to one of the entries, I can use my left and right arrows to open or collapse that. So it allows me to navigate through the tree. In the file area, you'll notice that there are all the typical operations that you would expect. There's the save, which will save that onto your hard drive. Save as will allow you to save directly to a thumb drive or portable media, or it will let you rename a file. You can open, merge, start a new show file, and there are some export and import tools that we will cover later. Below file are the exit and power off device commands. Exit will allow you to leave the EOS software and go into the shell, and the power off device allows you to shut down the console from within the browser. You can show and hide the CIA by using the arrow at the top. So if I hit the down arrow, that's going to collapse that. That gives me a little bit of more screen real estate if I need it, and I can pop it up as well to regain focus of it. And if I decide that I want to keep it from popping up and down, I can put the lock pad on, and that will keep it in its position.